Hey guys, it's Done for Games, and as you may already have guessed, Final Fantasy XI has once again pulled me back into its clutches one more time. I mean, I always say this one more time, but seriously, last time. With a decreasing population and numerous aging systems that don't really work anymore in today's day and age of gaming, countless changes have been introduced to this game over the past few years since I last uninstalled this classic MMO. I'm still figuring out most of the new stuff. Seriously, there's like a shitload. But I thought I'd put together this list of the top 5 things that have changed the way that I play Final Fantasy XI compared to how I used to play it. If you're thinking of coming back, hopefully it'll either get you rolling or convince you to avoid it altogether if it's no longer the MMO for you. So, tip number 1, trusts. Depending on when you left like me, this wasn't even a thing, but trusts basically make up the game now. Trusts are alter egos of all of your favorite or most despised storyline NPCs, and they can be summoned to fill in missing gaps in your party, like all the other party members that are no longer leveling. These are pretty much all the jobs, like Red Mage Support, Bard, Paladin, Rune Fencer, White Mage, Samurais, Dark Knights, whatever you want. Some of them are incredibly powerful, and when you can get a full party of 5 others and then you, catching up on job levels or merits has never been easier. It is kind of funny that some of the trusts are like really good, like Zai 2 is throwing out like 3000 damage weapon skills, and then like Nishmira is like, I still suck. On top of that, pretty much all mission level caps have been removed. Between that and these helpful trust buggers, completing any of the expansions that you might have missed out on is way easier than it was back in the day. After an initial trust questline, how to obtain other trusts varies, but it's usually not too bad. No longer do I need to wait till a Red Mage or Bard pop out of the woodwork. I just have one whenever I want. Bringing us to tip number 2, reasons to do those expansions that you only like sort of halfway finished. I'm looking at you, Wings of the Goddess. With a curtain drawing to a close, Square Enix introduced the Rhapsodies of vana'diel mission, tying together all of the previous expansions into one cohesive and nostalgic storyline. You'll need a certain amount of progress into each expansion to progress further in Rhapsody, encouraging you to finally finish up those stories. I'm really excited to like do the high-ranking Zillart missions, the really tough stuff, and finish them you will, because Rhapsodies provides some seriously awesome key item bonuses throughout its storyline. Key items that provide huge XP bonuses, items for sale at Moogle vendors, like ninja tools and food, stuff you can't really find as easily anymore now that the player base has decreased and less people are crafting it. Go back and kick Bahamut's ass, like face roll him. The experience boost alone is worth it, but some more unique hidden bonuses are in there as well, like how often you can enter certain battlefields and how many trusts you can summon. Starting out at 3, you can get all the way up to 5. Great stuff. I might fight Promethea again just because. Just because. And the story's just been awesome so far, so I highly recommend it being your first objective. I haven't figured out how to do it yet, but I'm popping Genbu and I'm kicking his ass. Speaking of which, doing those expansions of Rhapsody's missions won't be anywhere near as hard as it once was, thanks to tip number 3, new warps! Oh my god, if only this was a thing back in the day, but any home point crystal can now warp you to any other home point crystal after you've clicked on it and activated. These are obviously all over the place, and I bet you don't remember any of the locations because there was never a use for them. You always had your home point in Juno, or Onargon, or one of the main cities, or maybe your hometown. Never like Norg. You still gotta think out, you're like, what's the best route to that location? I've got a home point over there. On top of that, floating book survival guides, which can also be seen on the map now, can be teleported too, from any other survival guide. Between the two of these alone, most corners of vana'diel can be reached with ease now, at least after visit number 1. So don't forget to click them as you're running around and you see them just sitting there.
I could teleport to the outpost that I ran an outpost run like 10 years ago.
So tip number 4, figuring out where you are in those quests is pretty easy now too, thanks to the Records of Eminence system. This is an end-all, be-all, what have you done, what are you currently doing in-game system. Basically every kill 10 of these monsters, collect 10 of these items, finish these missions, quest, all rolled into one huge gigantic thing. It is cool that like every 10 seconds, like you got 10 Rarob Tails, Records of Eminence. It's under quests and you can run through and select all the stuff that you did back in the day and activate stuff that you're currently doing, like acquiring Beastman Seals, kill 200 enemies, deal 500 damage, that sort of thing. Just keep them all active all the time. You did 500 damage 20 times. Records of Eminence. The huge benefit to doing this is the Sparks of Eminence as a reward, which can be traded for great starter level 99 equipment and all the pages required to upgrade your artifact, relic, or Empyrean gear. You died 30 times in a row. Records of Eminence. I'm kidding, that's not one, but that would be cool. Bring me to dun-dun-dun, tip number 5. All that awesome artifact and relic gear you haven't worn since the level cap was raised past 75, it's useful again. Using an upgrade process of these pages and other item requirements unique to each gear piece, you can raise the gear to I level 109, and then once again at the plus 1 version of I level 119, which is awesome. Each has some really cool and unique awesome stats, like the Black Mage AF body returning 2% of all black magic damage done as MP? Hell yes! Anyways, it's a really neat little system, and I'm glad to see those classic gear sets making a return to the spotlight. Come on, the artifact gear was amazing back in the day. Even back then it wasn't that good though, a lot of pieces were awful. Most of the Dragoon AF is terrible, but looks amazing. Anyways, there's plenty more shit going on, but I could talk for hours and hours and hours and not fully flesh out all of the changes and new stuff that came to Final Fantasy XI in the past few years. Is it totally different than it was in 2008? Yes, you betcha. Can it still be fun? Totally, depending on what drew you to the game in the first place. I'm going after Leaping Lizzie and I'm gonna get those boots because, oh my god. For better or worse, the days of needing a full party of 6 to level are gone, as are shouting for hours and hours to get a party together to go fight Fenrir, but it can still be great to go back and do that stuff that you didn't get to do by yourself or in a small group. You can still grab 6 people, you just don't need to. Christmas Eve, 2007. I camped all day. I was just at home and I just camped Leaping Lizzie, and I killed him 11 times in a row, and they wouldn't drop. Let me know in the comments if you've been playing Final Fantasy XI again, or if you're smarter than me and haven't touched it in ages because you're not dumb. Like the video if it brings you back to 2006, and dislike it if you think that old MMOs like this should just kind of roll over and die. I hope not. Please don't. Subscribe either way, because come on, you've made it this far, and I've got plenty of new videos coming each week that I really want to see you guys back for, so thanks for watching. It doesn't fit his character at all, but I would love to see an episode of Archer where he, like, gets super addicted to an MMO. I mean, that'd just be hysterical.